Tabligh Jamaat, a confirmed terror outfit. Who says the Tabligh Jamaat is not a terrorist organization? Also, the Nizamuddin congregation, or Markaz, which is unfolding as a well-planned conspiracy. Maybe loudmouth journo and promoter of the Republic TV channel, Arnab Goswami, dare dismiss it. Of late, Arnab seems to have lost his professional balance with which he spearheaded the channel. That Tabligh Jamaat incident cannot be dismissed as communal, or it does not represent entire Muslim community, is nothing but ignorance of facts. Interestingly, most true credible columnists, S Gurumurthy and Brigadier retired GB Reddi, have come out with undisputable evidences to prove that Tabligh Jamaat is nothing but yet another ISIS arm and its involvement in major terror attacks either in France or Great Britain or elsewhere in the world, sufficient to justify its sinister jihadi movement. In that backdrop, one needs to look at the origins of Tabligh Jamaat and its primary purpose or end objective. The Tabligh Jamaat has been projecting itself as a conservative global educational and missionary movement set up in 1926 by Maulana Muhammad Ilyas in Mewat in present-day Haryana. He also happens to be the grandfather of Amir Maulana Saad, its present head. Tabligh Jamaat has been successfully operating in near secrecy. In France, with 80% of the Islamist extremists have come from Tabligh Jamaat ranks. French intelligence officers prompted to call it as the antechamber of fundamentalism. Tabligh Jamaat is the biggest Muslim movement in the world, with 150 to 250 million adherents fanned out in as many as 180 to 200 countries. Most of its followers are of South Asian region. Hence, its links with Zakir Naik's IFR cannot be ruled out, and it is considered as the most influential religious movements in 20th century Islam. Tabligh Jamaat terror mayhem include September 11th attack in United States, the US Embassy attack in Paris, the Portland 7, the Lackawanna 6, the 2006 transatlantic aircraft plot, the 7x7 London bombings, the 2007 London car bombs, and 2007 Glasgow International Airport attack. That apart, Tabligh Jamaat members were also involved in Pakistan politics, the established hub of terror groups, and in the West. Former Pakistan Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, whose father was a prominent Tabligh member and financier, also helped Tabligh members to take prominent political positions. In that backdrop, how can anyone dare dismiss the Markaz at Nizamuddin not a conspiracy against India? Only insane do so. Modi government should not hesitate to ban Tabligh Jamaat and also order a probe and put a stop to the nefarious activity in India. Modi government should seize the Nizamuddin building and also freeze all bank accounts of Tabligh Jamaat. This is K. Ramakrishna for Orange News 9 TV.